69 look. Come on, all a lot of retrobuilt. This is by the Duncan Brothers. They've done a nice job of changing and taking some of the best of the retrobuilt cars. Boss SCT Mustang. What is the Boss SCT Mustang, you ask? It is by the Duncan Brothers, who have split off from Retrobuilt. And this is their first build. That's for WWE superstar Trevor Mann.
It's already cool. This is like exactly what I put it. Like not even the same car, like
yeah, man.
It's so like
all right, guys, we're here at SEMA 2019. We're here with the Duncan Brothers. Come on in. We got most of the guys. We're missing Joe, I think, right?
Joe's yeah, right. I think we got five out of six.
That's five out of six. So you guys want to say hello, introduce yourselves, and tell us a little bit about where you guys are located, and of course, what you're building. So,
My name is Aaron Duncan, and I am the Chief Strategy Officer and one of the designers at Duncan Brothers Customs. And this man is?
I'm Rick Duncan. I'm the owner of Duncan Brothers Customs. I'm second generation Duncan. He's third generation. First generation.
Randy Duncan. I'm Rick's twin brother. I do most of the body work, painting the cars.
Danny Duncan, cousin to the Duncan Brothers over here, and our fathers were the ones that originated this from.
Cool. Justin Byram, the only non-Duncan in the group. More big head, yeah. Do whatever they need me to.
Awesome, guys. Well, these guys are taking what Retrobuilt started and take it to a whole other level. So we're going to show some of their beautiful craftsmanship and handiwork right here. We're going to talk about what's next and how you can contact them and get one of your own. So, all right, guys. All right, so we've got a 2010, right?
Yes, sir.
And this was previously looked a little different, right?
Yeah. This was, and you can probably find photos of it online. This was a prototype car from Retrobuilt Motors, a company that I worked for previously, and I was always a big, big fan of their work, but even before I worked with them or was in the industry, I always said, man, if I could ever just get my hands on one and really have an unlimited budget, unlimited time with it, I really feel like we could dial in. My buddy had bought this prototype car. This was their second one they had built. And it was white and black and
it was dressed like a Boss show too, right?
Yeah. And before that, because it was a prototype car, it was their first 69 Shelby. And some of the, and even Retrobuilt would agree, some of the proportions were a little weird. Some of the, it was
mostly in the haunches, right? Yeah. That tended to be where it looked a little weird. And so you guys have taken this now and given it more of a traditional 69 Fastback look.
Absolutely.
Sportsroof look.
We ended up taking an actual 69 taillight panel and taking, you know, the 10s come and swoop down like this. And they used that existing thing. And even though this car was a 2010, what Retrobuilt actually did was they used a 2005 to 2009 taillight and just put covers on it. And
it looked flat, right? It kind of had a flat look to it.
It had a flat look to it. And the angle was kind of weird. Like, you really had to be on it at the right angle for it to
look. And the
look.
Bumper looked...
was too gapped.
It was
okay. far too gapped. So we took a real 69 taillight panel and then made closeout panels.
That's
in the 69
trunk. Valance that you've modified?
We actually handmade that valance.
Did you really?
Yeah. Was 100% responsible for handmaking that valance from the bottom. So you raised the bumper up about 3/4 of an inch to meet the correct location for the 69 taillight panel. But what always happens is we thought the butt was too heavy. So what we ended up doing to correct that, we raised the bumper up 3/4 of an inch and then decided to drop the whole back of the car an inch and a half. So the bumper sits lower than it used to, but on the body itself, it's in the correct place.
Right, the stance is lower too.
Yeah, the stance is correct.
This is bonded on, or the rear quarter is bonded on?
Yes.
And these are hand fastened house?
Yes.
Fiberglass?
Fiberglass.
Yeah, they are. So to make this work, this looks like it's got a little bit higher kick than a normal 69 would have to it. There is a subtle built-in spoiler, but this is built up a little bit.
Let's do a full closeout panel. We added a piece we fabricated out of sheet metal in shop, welded it all in to fill this out, and then what we did is we cut into the deck lid. Basically, this section that dipped down, we completely cut out, and refinished it out so you have a much cleaner, more accurate to a 69 look. This is actually a custom guitar that a guitar maker made that actually fits the car too, and we're going to show that to the owner here soon. The owner hasn't seen it yet.
Gotcha. Yeah, it's pretty amazing. There's actually a lot of space in here.
And fortunately for us, I mean, even it being a prototype car, Retrobuilt gave us a good template to work with. You know, so much of it was still utilized, but so much of it, you know,
you can take it to the next level.
Yeah, yeah. I'll say this. If this wasn't Trevor's car, we probably wouldn't have done it because he already owned it. He had the sentiment right to it. It would have been easier for us to probably start from scratch. Because when you're going in over top of someone else's work, it's so much harder to make it.
Let's talk about some of the other changes you guys made. Absolutely. It's a little tight on this side, guys. Sorry,
Do you guys want to go over there?
Yeah, let's take a look at that. It's a 2010, you know, Mustang GT inside.
Yeah, and we did a Leah leather interior on this one. You know, and a custom kit to kind of match the car, the blue stitching, the gray inserts, even the door inserts are gray. Gray with the blue stitching and the black bolsters. SoCal Garage Works actually made the steering wheel for us, and this is pretty cool because it's a D-cut race style steering wheel.
Is that Alcantara?
Yeah, Alcantara, absolutely.
Yeah, pretty good.
And the cool thing about it is it's got the D-cut, but you can still retain all the buttons. Probably one of the biggest changes in my mind.
I mean, how in the world? I can't even imagine what it took to get those things going.
Oh yeah, I mean, that's once again even something that Retrobuilt was able to lay out for us and us kind of utilize what they had done. And even, I mean, we had a little bit of work to do too because they kept sticking, so we did some prevention to make them stop. But probably one of the biggest things we did that's a change to these cars that to me, here's what's interesting. When I was with Retrobuilt and when we did that, one of the biggest complaints was, well, there's no quarter window on the car for the 69 cars. There's no quarter window. And I realized it wasn't the quarter window that was the problem. It was that the roof line that they were expecting
it,
from the quarter.
It cut off right here. And so on the Shelby stuff, I noticed they put some things in here, like they lubricated.
Yeah, they put like a snake or something right there to kind of take your eye from it. But you have to have this shape on there. There's no way around it. So we actually cut in right here, and you know, you can actually feel back here. On a 2010 Mustang, you have an actual quarter window right here, and you got, you know, just blankness right here. So we cut into the fiberglass and made it to the shape that we wanted, but we still had a little bit of the quarter window showing. So we had to weld metal to the existing metal that was on there,
right,
and then smooth it over, and then so it kind of gave it that recessed look. And at the same time, you know, we added the trim to it just to recess a little bit more. And it's crazy, especially when the windows are up outside. It really, really looks like a window. It looks like a blacked out window.
Right. But this is all reverse, right? You guys went gloss.
Absolutely. I'm glad you said that because we wanted to do a negative image or a reverse of what a 69 Boss would normally be. So everything, we made a goal, made a note that everything that was normally matte on the car would be gloss, and the body, which is normally the gloss color, was going to be matte,
right?
Which presented its own issues and problems and all that stuff. But
yeah, so this would normally be flat black hood, flat black shaker. Mm-hmm. This would all be low gloss black along with the spoiler. They've just done this in a nice matte gray finish, right?
And yeah, and we did, you know, other things talking about the back, we did roll the corners a little bit. So
let's go on the other side, Aaron. You're probably easy to
see it.
We want to look in here,
yeah.
Let's open the door, kind of see.
So you got your modern comforts, and you can take it across the country and back and be good to go. This is Trevor or Ricochet, I think it's more people on the internet's going to know him as Ricochet than Trevor.
Right. Well, he's local, right? You guys grew up with him.
Boys from way back when. Yeah. In sixth grade, I met that dude, and he was breakdancing. So, but yeah.
No, that's cool to see, though. I mean, it's nice to see, like, somebody from hometown do good.
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
And in my opinion, one of the biggest changes we made that no one would notice if we didn't make this change was the 69 buckets actually go about to right here. And on the Retrobuilt cars, they kind of did this thing where the line went straight and tucked in. Yeah, exactly. And we call it hockey stick. Dog leg's a great term. So what we did was we actually notched the headlight buckets so that way we just have a smooth straight line. No one would be the wiser, and it's weird how much it kind of shrunk up the front.
Right.
And I switched the hood pins to 70 style hood pins. And the main reason that we twist off style hood pins, so now you don't have to worry about losing them again.
Yeah, that's right.
Dude, this is awesome.
The raccoon stayed in the car the whole time.
Never mind.
That's great, Duncan.
And I both had a bad habit of taking the hood pins out and stick them in our back pocket and lose them. Yeah. So,
way because where the fenders sit on,
yes,
there's no way to widen this part of it.
Exactly. So the fenders have, because, you know, the factory mounting points for the S197 is where we mount the fenders.
So you're limited. Unless you did some type of wide body thing, right? Push these out?
But even then, you'd be getting into some real estate on the car that you wouldn't want to get into, like where your shock tower is located, a couple other things. So you pretty much, you're married to it right there.
So this is a stock 69 hood, 70 hood that you guys modified?
No. This was a fiberglass hood that was on the car initially, and we modified it.
Making these additional changes.
Traditional changes. These are real 69 buckets that we actually cut and basically did it to where we have the line right here. When I raise the hood, you'll see it, how we notched it.
That's a lot of work.
This is badass.
Look at the valve cover covers.
Yeah, the motor is completely different.
This is so, everything is different about it.
Have you made it to the back end yet?
I have not.
69 front bumper on it, 69 grill?
Yes, sir. Well, the 69, it's actually an aftermarket one that's been widened just a little bit, so that way it would give us a more even one. And these are legit 5¾-inch, 69 aftermarket headlights. So. But one cool thing before we pop the hood, because you were asking about the reverse on the stripes, we did the blue to kind of celebrate this being the SCT color blue.
Right.
You know, they're blue.
For those that don't know, SCT is what? Who?
SCT tuning. So if you have a tuner, an X4, an X3, most people that have a Mustang, a lot of them are using SCT tuners. I think right now they're probably using the BDX tuners. That's the newest one. Before we get under the hood, I want Randy to tell you about how we achieved the side stripes. Because the interesting thing is, if you feel it, there's really not much of an edge, and we had to kind of do a magic trick to make it work. So, Randy, you want to talk about that before we pop the hood?
I guess I'll have to. We had the car painted by the painter, and it was just too much tape line. It was just way too much tape line.
Too much of a tape line.
So we had him sand it completely off, and what we did is we laid all the base on before we put the clear, then laid the blue on, then went over that with the satin clear. We did not paint any of the black. And once it was all done, I retaped the whole surround of the blue and taped where I wanted the black. And I used a buffer no bigger than that. And I buffed all that black back to shine from the satin.
Wow. So these are not stickers or decals.
They are not stickers.
That's all painted on.
All painted on. We did not want to say Boss 302 because we wanted to, obviously it's not a 302 motor, it's a 306. It just fit to that Boss SCT.
Yeah. So Randy, same thing up here, right? You guys do the same process?
Yeah.
That's awesome, guys. Well, and that looks like an original aluminum shaker scoop?
That's a CDC shaker from a classic design concept.
Well, that's a composite one. Yeah.
And we painted it because, once again, with the reverse,
right,
we want that.
But I think they used the mold for that as the identical to the
aftermarket. They did, and I think you can actually buy aftermarket shakers for them or a 69% model. It's gas, for sure. But one of the biggest things is we couldn't convince Trevor to change the motor to a Coyote, and I have nothing against performance on three valves. I have a soft spot for them, especially the sound of them.
Right.
But they're the ugliest motor Ford ever put out. They are ugly.
Yeah, they're not aesthetically the most pleasing, right?
So we really, really, really wanted to change that. And I think we set a goal for ourselves to try to make this the best looking 4.6 3-valve engine bay that we possibly could.
Got it.
And, I'll lean you over to Dad because a lot of that was his department.
Okay.
Relocated our hood latch too.
This is the original 4.6 3-valve motor, but when Aaron gets a crazy idea, and he's got some craziness, let me tell you, he wanted to cover everything up as much as he could, and I don't know how he was going to do it, so we just started from scratch. This is sheet metal, it's all welded together, I mean covers to bolt on, but just hides all the injectors, all the coils, it hides everything. This panel we had to make, because the car's about 4 inches longer, 5 inches longer than a standard 2010, so we had to create our own radiator shroud. It's all metal. It's actually formed out of 8 different pieces, and each piece had its own design, either rolled in it or relief in it, the dimple dies, and then all welded each other together and finished it out. So
that way we don't have a ton of negative space in here when you open that.
And it's aesthetically pleasing too.
Yeah.
This is badass.
Look at the valve cover covers.
Yeah, the motor is completely different.
This is so Everything is different about it.
That the hood latch originally is up here. I fabbed up a newer catch there and moved the hood latch down so that it would just go through the slot and then close the hood.
So any mods other than the cold air intake and obviously the shaker setup?
It's got Brent Speed Detroit Rocker cams in it, but for the most part it's just the Brent Speed Detroit Rocker cams, cold air intake, headers, what'd you say?
And a tune.
Yeah, and a tune. A 93 octane tune from Brent Speed. And then it's got, it's actually got QuickTime cutouts on it. So Trevor wants
it. It's loud.
So yeah, it can be loud really or loud. It can be quiet.
Now, something to point out too, you guys are going to be doing any 05 at this point, any 05 to 14.
That's correct.
But the long term goal is you guys are going to possibly do, not possibly, you're going to start doing S550s, experimenting to see what that might look like.
Yeah.
But
we've got a customer now that's actually from the SEMA show that's bringing us a, what year is his first car?
He's got an 09, I think.
Okay, that one and an S550.
Yeah, so.
And so that'll be your prototype for the
S550. That'll be the prototype car. We told him it's probably a year out as far as actually being able to deliver it back to him, a year and a half, we told him.
Yeah.
And but we are to build it.
Well, you'd be amazed how similar the wheelbase of the S550 is to an actual 69 Mustang. Yeah.
Building on what you said, yes, we got the
roof line clearly,
and then up to the S550s, but it doesn't matter if it's a 67, 68, Fastback, convertible, Shelby, 6970, we can build any of them.
Yeah. Cool. The other thing to realize too, guys, is they a lot of these, I mean, again, 05 all the way up to 14, so you can convert pretty much any of them. So if you want a Coyote, just get an 11 and up, right? Yeah. And I mean, the ideal donor car would be something that had hail damage, right? I mean, something that hadn't been wrecked, maybe, or even stuff that's been mildly damaged, because you're going to be changing out so many body panels and parts anyway.
Well, there's the interesting market, too. Someone might not like the looks of the S550, and they have, let's say, an S197 that they have sentiment in, but they're kind of ready for something new, and that's where we are the guys to, like, we'll give you something. We won't give you something new, but we'll give you something that looks old.
Right. So. Now, we never talk about price points that much, because I know every build's different. Can you give me a ballpark, though? I've got, let's just say, for the heck of it, I've got a 2011, 12 S197, and I want to make it look like a 69 Mustang, or I want to make it look like a 69 Fastback. I don't want any power out, I just want, you know, paint body and switch it over.
Just paint body, you're not worried about wheels, you're not worried about interior or anything else.
Yeah, convert it to look like a 69.
I think you're looking at about 50 grand on that.
50. Yep. And then bells and whistles as you go, right?
Bells and whistles as you go. So.
Yeah, this car's got four major options: the Wilwood brakes, the American Racing wheels, the aluminum leather interior, and the custom steering wheel. And those four options were 15 grand.
Wish you best of luck, and I'll put all the links down below, guys, and you can watch if you have any questions, hit them up.
Thank you.
All right, boys. Thanks, guys.